تعالى إن الذين يؤذون الله ورسوله لعنهم الله في الدنيا والآخرة. That a person who harms and calls the noble parents of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and disbelievers, they are cursed. Why? Because they are harming the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they are harming Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why our ulama and the ulama of the Ahl Sunnah, our adab was that whenever we mentioned the name of Sayyidina Abdullah and Sayyidina Amina, we would mention radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And the Shaykh is with me in Damascus, in Aleppo, there's a mosque that is actually named Jami'a Amina bint Wahab, radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And this is how our scholars used to respect the lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And unfortunately, we have today people actually attacking the lineage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that's why Alama Iqbal, he used to say that wafaqa kash maut se darta nahi ruhi muhammad uske badan se nikal do. A Muslim believer, he's not fearful of anything. One thing we can actually weaken him is take the ruhi muhammad, that love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from his soul. And that's how we see today the Muslims, some sects of the Muslims and the non-Muslims, they're doing, they're attacking us within, they're taking the love of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from our hearts. We need to be guarded against this, and the fitna is going to get worse and worse. We need to understand who are the true scholars, and we need to understand who are the true people and who are true to follow. And I'll finish off with the story of Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu and his love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam departed from this dunya, Sayyidina Bilal could not take it. It was just so much for him. So he migrated to Syria. He left from Medina Sharif and he went to Syria. And he spent many years in Syria. One night the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to Sayyidina Bilal's dreams and he said, "Oh Bilal, do you not miss us? You have left us for how long? Do you not come back to meet us?" And Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that day he woke up and he went back to Medina Sharif. And when people saw Sayyidina Bilal coming, the muadhin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Marhaba ya muadhin," they welcomed Sayyidina Bilal. And when it came for the salah time, they said, "Oh Bilal, can you read that same azan that you used to do when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to amongst us?" When Sayyidina Bilal would do the azan, it was like the azan would be carried by the sweet winds of Medina. It would enter the house of the people and the people would come running up to come to pray because they knew that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is going to be in the mosque and we're going to see the beautiful face of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sayyidina Bilal says, "I do not have enough power in me to do this azan." And after that, the Sahaba, they said, we shall